Well, hello there again, my YouTube friends. This is a video for a YouTube user called Therion. I think it's Therion or the Ryan. I'm not sure if you've got your name right, but I hope it's pretty close. I think I'll say Therion. Seems better and easier to say. Okay, so he asked how you actually clean the switches, the actual switch part on these MX Revolution mice. I'm not going to do the take apart or the tear down of the mouse again. All I'm going to do is the tear down from this particular point and then show you how I do the switches. This is going on from the last video. If you're following my last I'll just set the camera up right. If you follow the last video, you'll find I've got the only point I've got to is where I've taken this ribbon cable out. That's the only point. So if you follow the last video from there, you'll get to the point where I am now. I'm not going to do the take apart thing, you know, the top cover. Basically it's just four screws underneath the feet, the Teflon feet, and then the top comes off. And then just be careful, as always, with that little ribbon cable. You know, don't rip the mouse apart or you could damage that. Not sure how easy or even if that is possible to get hold of again. I wouldn't have thought so. You'd have to buy another mouse, a second hand one, hopefully with that in it. Anyway, I digress. First off, on this part is this battery clamp. You can only take it off from, it's best to take it off from that side, because this side has a longer part that fits underneath. So if you try and lever it out this side, you'll find you're bending this to an extreme level to get it out. It's easier to do it from this side because this is the shortest level. I'll show the shortest clip. I'll show you. You just lift it up and slide it across, and then as you can see on that clip there, you've got a long side and a short side there. It's always easy to take it off that side because you're levering a hell of a lot to get it under there, and you know, you might bend it or even break some of the plastic components here. Next up is the battery. You don't have to take all this stuff off. Actually, the reason I'm taking all this apart is because I'm replacing this switch. You can still get them. I've just got a bag off eBay. Cost me £4.50 postage for 10 switches. Part number. I'll probably put the part number in the link. Let's take my glasses off so I can see what I'm looking at. They're OMRON switches. Actually, are these on? Yes, these are OMRON switches. Part number is D2FC. F for Freddy, C for Charlie. Little dash, F for Freddy. Little dash, 7N for Norman. And those are the switches. They're the exact part number of the ones in the mice. So if you ever wanted to, a lot of mice use these switches, same part number, so you know they're compatible with quite a few. The switch, let me have a go on the switch. Okay, I'll do this thing for Therion first, and I'll just show him how I lubricate these switches. You want switch cleaner, obviously. I'm always referring to switch and contact cleaner in my video. The switch and contact cleaner I use is Servisol Super 10, which is good stuff. It's rather expensive. It's about, oh, I don't know, I've got loads of tins, but I buy it in bulk, you see, so I think separately you pay £8 or £9, something like that, for a tin, which is quite expensive, but it will last you, you know, a few years if you're not using it all the time. Okay, carry on. This is your part. I'll just zoom in on that switch bit. There. A bit more even. Oh, not too much. There we go. And basically, if you're just doing the switch, if you just want to lubricate the switch, all you have to do is get yourself a little spudger. A little plastic spudger. That's the name of the tool, by the way. And just lever the switch down. Probably better using the flat end. Lever it down and back a little bit if you can. Probably down's enough. give the switch cleaner a shake and just put it on, and you'll see it disappearing into the switch, and you might even see it coming out the bottom. You can see it on the video. And all you do is keep pressing the switch like that. I've probably put some in this before, quite some time ago, but this switch is actually faulty now, so the rest of the video is going to be on replacing the switch, which you can do if the switch is suffering from the dreaded double click, which these mice seem to suffer from. I'm not sure if it's the mouse itself or the... I mean, I've had quite a few mice and none of them really have suffered from this problem as much as the MX Revolution, so I'm not sure whether it's a switch problem or a maybe a plastic lever problem in the mouse itself. It could be the levering that's done in the top part of the mouse. I've used quite a few Logitech mice, and this is the main one. It's actually the left mouse click that always seems to be the problem. Anyway, just keep doing that, and put some more on if necessary. If it's the first time you've done the switch, if you hold the switch down like that, you'll see a load of bubbles come out of it. Obviously the air from inside the switch. If you keep pressing it until all the bubbles have stopped coming out, you know the switch's internals have been saturated with the cleaner, and that's what you want. Now, we're not going to leave all that in there. If you leave it in for 10 minutes, something like that, dry it all off at the top and the bottom. If you've got some compressed air, you could possibly use a little bit of that just to blow, any excess cleaner out, but you don't have to. It won't do any harm staying in there, because this stuff actually acts like a lubricant as well. Once the main ingredients in the switch cleaner, or the accelerant in the switch cleaner, have evaporated, it actually leaves a fine film of lubricant on the switch contacts, and this is what aids in the future operation of the switch, because even with these tiny switches, when they're being pressed, there'll actually be a tiny arc inside the switch, and it's that arcing and burning that can cause the switch to stick, not open or close properly, and that could be what's relating to the double bounce or the double click. Anyway, so Therion, yeah, that's all you do with the switch if you want it cleaning out. Okay, so now I'll move on to the switch replacement. You can also do this as well if you've got clicky switch double click problems. Just replace the switch and be done with it. The switches are actually cheaper than the switch cleaner. Okay, so battery off. It's just a little clip on the top. There, all you do is pull the clip back. Battery will lever forwards, and then lift up and then slide it out that way. You can't actually pull it out at this point. You have to slide it through this gap and turn it over like that, because under this part there's two screws. There's one there and one hidden down this hole. Only little tiny screws. You don't need any special tools or anything like that. All the screws are the same size. Just leave it in there. And then you just lift that plastic part off, or leave the screw in there. And then underneath you've got the connector for the battery. Don't pull it by the battery. Get the wires if you can. If you've not got a tool to do this, I've got tools to do this, but you can use the spudger or a screwdriver just to lever it very lightly. But at this point I must warn you, if you're going to use a screwdriver to lever these things out, be really careful, because if the screwdriver slips, you can easily take these SMD components off the board, especially like this inductor. I need these little tiny resistors and capacitors. They're so easy to knock off. So the easiest way is just to grab the wires as a bunch and just lever them very slightly and pull on them all together. You'll see, not straining one particular wire. It should come out just like that. So we'll put him safely over there. Next thing to come off, we've got to take this board off to do the switch. You can't you probably could. Once you take this off, let's take this wheel off. The wheel is only held on with one screw. In fact, first, what I'll do is I'll pull this wire off. This is the power to the motor. There's a little vibrating motor in there. Yeah, so we'll have to take this off first. Keep hold of the board, both wires together, and it'll just pop off. And then, don't need to touch any of these screws. And then, undo this one. You will notice, be careful at the front when you're undoing this one, because there's a little piece that comes off. Once you've got the screw out, the wheel just lifts off, and then you'll see a little piece that probably fall off. They normally fall off. No, it didn't fall off today. All it is a little pivot, and it slides off there. It's just where the you've got the rotation shaft for the wheel to rock side to side. Just make sure you keep that safe. You can't put it on the wrong way round or anything like that. Well, you could if you tried, but basically you've got a hole in the back of there and a little pointy locator on the end. On the bottom of the mouse, it just slides in like that, and then you just carefully turn it over, keeping it together, and that's how you fit it back on. Also, you've got a spring here. That's the actual press button for the mouse. That gives you your spring force. It won't come out, that spring, unless you pull it out, obviously. It doesn't just fly out like when you open the back of a watch. And to get the board off, all you need to do is desolder the charge contacts. This is the part that contacts your charging plate or your charging contacts on your dock. It's always a good idea to keep them clean too. Little gold plated contacts do oxidise. I'm not sure if you can see on there, but the contacts, the contacts have gone a bit green, and they do actually darken off over time with oxidisation. And a lot of charging problems with these mice, with in relation to the docks, is it's just oxidisation on the contacts. And what a lot of people say, and I've found, is if you put this mouse in the dock and just leave it, you come back to it, I don't know, a few hours later, you think, oh, my mouse is charged. Pick it up again, and it's actually not charged at all. You've put it in the dock, it's seated correctly, but the contacts have actually only been touching the oxidised film. They haven't actually been making full contact, so your mouse hasn't been charging. So it's a good idea to put a bit of switch cleaner on them every now and again. Keep them nice and clean. Okay, so now we'll desolder this little fella, or these little fellas. Just make sure my iron's on properly. And what I'm going to do with this is just let the weight of the base of the mouse pull the contacts apart when I've got them heated up. It's a little bit awkward. Not hard though. Don't bend the board too much away from the base of the mouse, because you can strain the board and also the gold contacts. But if you put a tiny bit of pressure on the base, you'll see it'll just fall away gradually. Do them alternately, a little bit at a time. You can use desolder braid if you like, or a desolder gun, or a desolder tool. But it's just as quick to do it like this, really. And that's that off. As I say, don't force it. Also, when you've got it off, just melt the solder off them pins, so it's easier to put back on. Okay, in fact, I think for this I will use the desolder braid. I hope you can see there. Right, let's get this little fella out. Just try and get as much solder off as you can, preferably all of it. It's not always possible though. I think it's just, if you just wiggle it like that, you can actually break the solder, but be very careful not to overheat the board for a start, because you don't want to pull the inserts in the holes out with the switch. And that's the old switch. And what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to refill these holes with solder. Simple reason is I need to get all the solder out of the holes properly before I put the new switch in. And if you get new fresh solder in the holes, it's easy to suck all of it out in one go with the solder wick. Sometimes when there's a part in there as well, you see it leaves a ridge of solder. If you look in those holes now, you can actually see the new switch will go through really easily. If there's any residue solder left in those holes, you'll end up forcing the switch through, possibly not only damaging the switch legs perhaps, but also the PCB, or the inserts in the PCB. Okay, new switch time. It's a new one, and I'll just show you this one's for a. Can you hear that? Nice click on that one. All we do is make sure you've got the white part of the switch facing the front of the board, because we do want it the right way round when we turn the board up the other way. Pop the legs through the hole. Get a tiny bit of flux. And I think we'll go down a size on the solder. I'm using half mil leaded solder for this. I don't use unleaded solder. I just don't like it. I can use it, but I just don't. What you want to do is first get a bit of solder on one of the legs, and then get ready with your finger, which is covered in flux now, and just re-wet that solder until the switch is actually sat down on the board properly, and then you can let go. Now straight to the other end, and then the middle, and then we'll just finish that one off. And that's it. That's the new switch in. Just let you have a closer look. Some flux remover. Now, if you're going to use flux remover quite often, it'll dry sticky. So, as well as the flux remover, I'm going to use some isopropyl alcohol and put plenty of that on there, just soak it really, and then dab it with a cloth. The switch also, make sure it's all nice and dry. And then, to finish off, don't just leave it with the isopropyl alcohol on it, because it's actually it'll actually dry the switch out, or it'll any lubricant that may be in the switch on the contacts, it'll dry out, and you don't want that, because you'll end up with the same problem that we're trying to alleviate. Okay, so what we do is we get our let me see, switch cleaner, and go same procedure as before. Let's see the bubbles coming out of that one, the new switch. Give it a clean. And now our new switch should last a long time. Hopefully. Nice and shiny, clean. If you want to, you can also put some contact cleaner on these little button switches. Normally they don't give as much of a problem as the big ones, but these are just either like a little membrane inside or a little metal plate, but they can get full of dust nevertheless, so a little spray with some switch cleaner won't do them any harm. One thing you can check is make sure the little switch on the back, let me see, come back, here, is located properly. And then you'll feel the mouse, the PCB snap onto the board. It's just the switch doesn't locate properly when you take the top of the board off. It just fits on. Like, see the little PCB SMD switch? It's just a little slide switch, and it fits in that slot. So you have to make sure that that's located just before you solder everything up. Okay, everything's sitting nice and flat. I'll just go up to a bigger gauge solder. This one is actually 0.8 mil. This is the biggest one I use. Use 0.8 and 0.5 mil solder. Make sure you're flat. If you put your finger on this transistor, that's actually flat when you press on that just a little bit. So you can do this one first. Get a contact, and then that'll do for this side then. Yep. That's okay. I'll show you that before I clean it up. In fact, I won't. I'll show you when I've cleaned it up. Same thing. Flux cleaner. Little brush. So you get all your solder joints cleaned up, and not only looks better, but it also stops any corrosion of the terminals or the solder joints in future if you clean it all off. Some of the flux that you can get is corrosive, or it can be corrosive to delicate parts. Still a little bit down there, but you can get that out after. We'll blow it out if necessary. Right, let's get this wheel back on. Okay, as I said before, best thing to do is put the connector on first. And then put the mouse down. And remember that little piece that we had before? The hole in the middle. And just slide that on. And then bring the mouse down, or the wheel down rather. And it just sits in position like that. Now it will fall off at this point until you put the screw back in. Just get a little screw and put that back in there like that. Doesn't need to be super tight or anything, and you'll find your mouse will just wobble around like that until you put the top back on. Push the wire down so it's out the way. Now next up is the battery and clip. So get our battery, same thing, just push the little clip in like that, and then always make sure you push you've got the wire reasonably straight, because then you have to put this top part back on. I don't know how many times I've put this on and then thought, you know, now the battery's got to go on, so I've got to take it off again. You can take the screws out of this, by the way. It sits on, actually it locates on like that. It's on two little lugs, so once that's on you can put your screws in. One in there, like that, and then bend your battery back over into the bottom slot, and then press it down into the top slot, and then we can put that little clip back on again with the largest side into this side, like that. Keep it forward that way, and then pull this side right out. And it just clips on like that. And that's where I started the video, I think. And that's our new switch in. If you want to know how it goes back together from here, it's only basically the ribbon cable on the top which slides in there. Just make sure you've got your little locking clip pulled upwards like that when you put the ribbon cable back in. If you leave it pressed down like that, you'll have a really good job on your hand trying to get the ribbon cable in there. It will actually go in, but you're actually meant to pull this up, push the ribbon cable in, and then lock the ribbon cable in like that. That's how you do it, and that's how it's supposed to be done. Okay, so Therion, I hope that explained the way I do the switches just with the lubricant. And for anyone else who needs the switches replacing, that's how I do them. So I hope that helped, and see you guys soon. Take care.